Use Rally's team planning to schedule work in iterations. Rally's team planning page makes it easy for your team to schedule prioritized work into iterations according to your capacity, giving you confidence in your ability to execute your plan for the PI. Use a team planning page during release or iteration planning to collaborate with fellow team members as you refine, estimate, rank, and schedule your work items according to the velocity you've planned for each iteration. Now it's crystal clear to see the work you can realistically do and the order in which it should be done without overcommitting your team. To start, navigate to the team planning page by selecting Plan, then Team Planning. Before using this page, it's important to have already administered the releases and iterations for your project from the Plan Time Boxes page. You'll need project administrator permissions to create time boxes, or perhaps your workspace administrator has already created them for you. To make changes to work items or to schedule them into an iteration or release, you'll need project edit permissions. To make changes to an iteration's velocity, you'll need at least project administrator permissions. Select the time frame that you'll plan by choosing the release in the drop-down menu. The team planning page has three views that correspond to the process you'll use to plan your iterations. The backlog view helps you identify the work your team will plan for the release and makes it easy to refine and prioritize that work. The planning view helps you schedule your prioritized work items into iterations based on the size of the work and the capacity of your team. The planned view gives your team and stakeholders an overview of the work that you've scheduled for each iteration. Let's begin by getting a prioritized list of work ready to schedule. First, let's use the backlog view. The backlog view shows you all the work items that can be scheduled into an iteration and that also fit the filtering criteria specified on the page. You may choose from some filter presets in the drop-down menu to get started. For example, the release backlog shows work items already assigned to the release you're planning. Or you may have unscheduled or unfinished work for features to consider. What about defects to fix? This is a quick way to pull work for prioritization. You may narrow down this work even more by selecting the Show Filters button and creating additional filters. Sort the work items by rank to prioritize them and make sure they have a plan estimate. You can edit it in line here along with a few other fields. This will be part of the decision-making process surrounding what will fit in an iteration. If you have work items with dependencies, this will also be important to note. Establish dependencies by selecting the work item ID or by selecting the gear icon and choosing Edit. Here you can indicate if a user story is dependent upon the completion of another user story. The dependencies feature is very important for making scheduling decisions. When you have enough work for the iterations you wish to plan, you're ready for the next step in the process. Let's move now to the planning view. As you can see, your backlog of possible work items to schedule is on the left, and the iteration plan for your team is on the right. In the right pane, you'll see an iteration name, the duration of the iteration, any issues that are flagged, the velocity for the iteration, and a visual indication of how the iteration has been scheduled, along with the percentage of capacity that's been scheduled for the iteration. At the bottom of the iteration list, you'll also see the release backlog. That is, all the work items you've already assigned to a release, but not an iteration. There's also a quick filter on the left for the team backlog to allow you to add more filters to narrow down your list. In this case, I've used filters to omit two of the items in the release backlog that needed further review. Expand the iteration or the release to see any work items that have already been scheduled in the time box. Have a discussion among members of the team to decide how much capacity you'll commit for each iteration, taking into consideration holidays, time off, events, all-day meetings, and other large time consumers that are not related to work delivery. Set the capacity for each iteration as a velocity number that the team can commit to getting accepted in the iteration timeframe. Once you've set the velocity for the iterations you're planning, you're ready to schedule work items. To schedule a work item into an iteration, drag it to the iteration, or select the gear icon next to the unscheduled work item and set the iteration that way. As you bring each work item into the iteration, check to make sure you're not exceeding the capacity your team agreed to for the iteration. You'll see an indication of the type and amount of work you're scheduling by the color, if you're associating colors with type of work or with features, and the percentage of capacity scheduled. If you schedule too much work for the velocity you've planned, the iteration name will turn red, as will your capacity percentage. You will also see an alert in the Issues column that you are over capacity. It's best to schedule work below 100% capacity to account for scope growth. Select the X next to the work item to return it to the release backlog, or you may use the gear menu to assign it to a later iteration, return it to the release backlog, or remove it from the plan altogether by unscheduling the release and the iteration. Sometimes you have the capacity for more work, but the next work item in priority is too large to schedule into the iteration. Look to the next item in priority to see if it makes sense to schedule it instead. You'll see this warning whenever you've scheduled work items that have not been estimated. Open the iteration and add the estimates for the work items that need them. This is important for reporting an accurate representation of your iteration capacity. Adjust your plan accordingly. As you review your plan for the iteration, consider dependencies. You may need to change the scheduling of a work item to a later iteration if an earlier work item needs to be finished first. Select the number in the dependencies column for details about dependencies associated with the work item. Some teams like to administer tasks as part of the iteration planning process. You may view, add, or change tasks from any of the team planning page views. Click the tasks icon or the blank box in the tasks column to interact with the tasks dialog box. From here, you may add, re-rank, change, or delete tasks associated with the work item. Select the X to return to the team planning page view. Your team members and stakeholders can get a summary of the iteration plan by selecting the planned view. This view focuses on the right panel of the planning view and presents all of the work items scheduled in each iteration, along with the capacity information. You'll also see what remains of the release backlog, the work that was considered for the release but didn't fit in the release. Congratulations! You have just learned how to create an iteration plan with your team using the team planning page. For your next iteration or sprint planning meeting, use the team planning page to schedule work items into the iteration. If you're curious about how to use a similar process to plan your PI, watch the Build Achievable Plans with Rally's Capacity Planning video and create a realistic plan for your next program increment. To learn more about Rally and Agile practices, check out our blog and community. Like this video and subscribe to our channel so that you never miss new content as it's added.